Harvard's problem of the week 88. This problem says that there is a ladder. The name of the problem is ladder envelope. It says there is a ladder which is shown in the figure as red color. It's vertical and lying against the wall initially. Later, a kick is given at the bottom of the ladder, because of which the ladder eventually falls down. While it is falling down, it's given that the bottom end is always in contact with the ground, while its top end is always in contact with the wall. The red color is the ladder's initial position, and after some time t, let us say this green color is the position of the ladder. It makes an angle theta degree with the ground. These yellow colored lines, dashed lines, are actually the axis drawn perpendicular to the velocities, and this we are going to use later actually. So first of all, what is asked in this question? Let us try to understand that. It's asking what is the envelope of the ladder's position. Means there will be different positions after different times. We have to find out the envelope made by these different ladder's position. So to visualize, first of all, let us look at how the different positions look like. And these are the different positions drawn of the ladder. Initially, the ladder was vertically lying against the wall. Its position was somewhat like this. Finally, it's lying horizontally against the wall. And in the meantime, at different times, I have drawn the positions of the ladder. You can see it's eventually falling down. First line, then second line, then third line, then fourth line. So now with this figure, now you can visualize the envelope made by the different ladders, and you can see this is the envelope. We are supposed to find out equation of this envelope, which is made by the different ladders position. This is asked in the question. Understood what is the envelope made by different positions of the ladders. Next, let's try to find out what is the relationship between ladder at any instant and the envelope. For this, we have drawn a rough diagram of the envelope, and this green color is ladder at any instant. Well, we can easily visualize that ladder at any instant has to be tangent to the envelope. It cannot intersect the envelope. That is the condition of the envelope, that at the point of contact, let us say P is the point of contact. If P is the point of contact with, let us say, XY coordinate, at the point of contact, the ladder has to be tangent to the envelope. Otherwise, it won't be envelope. The speciality about this point P on the ladder is that it has to be, its velocity has to be tangent to the envelope. And we know that ladder itself is the tangent to the envelope. Hence, velocity should be along the ladder. Velocity of point P should be along the ladder. This is a very important point. Velocity of point P should be along the ladder. This is the physical condition we are going to use to find out relationship between X and Y. Velocity of P should always be along the ladder. It can't be perpendicular to the ladder, otherwise, had there been any velocity at point P, a component of velocity at point P perpendicular to the ladder, it means this will intersect the ladder. It will no more be a tangent. Since it's a tangent, because of this condition, I can say that velocity of point P has to be along the ladder. So now our purpose is to find out at different instants all such points which are having a velocity along the ladder. We are supposed to find out locus of all such points which are having velocity along the ladder. So for this, we are going to use the concept of instantaneous center. Just imagine any body. Let us say this is a body. This point is having a velocity in this direction. let us say this is point A having a velocity Va, and let us say this point is having a velocity in this direction Vb, point is B. Its instantaneous center can be imagined as if at that particular instant it is rotating about that point or about that axis. So how to find out instantaneous center? I'll simply draw a perpendicular from point A, perpendicular to the velocity of A. I'll draw perpendicular to the velocity of B. Wherever these two meet is actually called instantaneous center of this body. It means at this particular instant, this body is rotating about this point. Okay. The use of instantaneous center is, now I can find out velocity of any point on this body. For example, this is point C and I want to find out velocity. At least I can say the direction of the velocity is going to be perpendicular to the line drawn from the instantaneous center to this position, and perpendicular to this. So this is going somewhere, this is going to be the direction of velocity. We can also find out the magnitude of the velocity, but that is not required here. So this is the concept of instantaneous velocity. To find out the instantaneous center, we'll draw these two lines, dashed lines, which are perpendicular to the velocities of point B and point A respectively. Wherever these two meet is going to be your instantaneous center. Here O dash is your instantaneous center. Now from this instantaneous center, I can find out the direction of velocity of any point of ladder. Okay, I am looking for that point which is actually moving along the ladder from O dash. O dash P is actually perpendicular drawn from O dash to the ladder. Now, since O dash is the instantaneous center, any point on the ladder will have velocity perpendicular to the line O dash P, the condition of instantaneous center. And here, perpendicular to the O dash P is along the ladder. Hence, I can say P is that point for which we are looking for. P is the point on which velocity is along the ladder. Let us say coordinates of the point P is xy. Our purpose is to find out relationship between xy. Well, I can say that O dash B in this figure is equals to L sine theta. L is the length of the ladder. From O dash B, if we look into triangle O dash PB, I can say that PB is equals to O dash B sine theta. Why? Because this angle is also theta. Actually equals to PH length, and that is equals to PB PB sine theta. By substituting PB from the previous equation and O dash B from the previous equation, I can say that Y is equals to L sine cube theta. We can find out X coordinate. We know from the figure that X, this length OH, is equals to OH, which is equals to OB minus HB. This implies X is equals to, what is OB? OB is L cos theta minus HB. HB is PB cos theta, and we know that PB is L sine square theta. So L sine square theta cos theta. If I take L cos theta common from here, I'll get 1 minus sine square theta. So this implies that X is equals to L cos cube theta. So we have found out a relationship between Y and X. It's a parametric relationship. I can finally summarize it as Y is equals to L sine cube theta and X is equals to L cos cube theta. from this I can say that sin theta is equals to y upon l to the power 1 by 3 and cos theta is equals to x upon l to the power 1 by 3. From the parametric form, we want to find out equation such that it gives a relationship between y and x directly. I would like to substitute theta here, and easiest way which I can see here is that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. So it means y upon l to the power 2 by 3 plus x upon l to the power 2 by 3 is equals to 1. This is the final locus of all such points which are having velocity along the ladder at different instants.